The Chinese auto industry is preparing to meet new emission regulations. In doing so, they will need to maximize control of a major source of VOCs, evaporative and refueling emissions. These emissions are fuel-based and can escape a vehicle during refueling, driving, or a diurnal parking cycle, a daily cycle involving temperature change. Current China 5 regulations allow for 2 grams of diurnal evaporative emissions per vehicle in a 24-hour period. China 6 will require automakers to reduce that number significantly, less than 700 milligrams per day in 2 consecutive 24-hour periods, including hot soak emissions and a deterioration factor. With proper design and quality materials, these numbers can be reached with currently available components. However, it takes a full understanding of the sources, control options, and testing protocols to find the best solution for each vehicle. Evaporative emissions come from 4 main mechanisms: the venting of the fuel and air induction system, permeation of fuel tank and hoses, leaks of the injectors and connections, and off-gassing of new components. Breaking down these sources into emission allotments can help create a blueprint for control. Start with the new 700 milligram allowance, subtract a 60 milligram deterioration factor, and a 130 milligram compliance margin to allow for differences in testing equipment and normal variations. The target for the entire vehicle is now only 510 milligrams. Here is one example of how to meet that goal. Non-fuel-based emissions, VOCs, emitted by new paint, plastics, adhesives, and tires are allotted 150 milligrams, leaving 360 milligrams to be divided equally between the powertrain and the fuel system. The powertrain includes the air induction system. Small drops of fuel around the fuel injector can evaporate and escape via the air intake system. Uncontrolled, the air induction system can emit as much as 300 milligrams of evaporative emissions a day, exceeding the allotment for the entire powertrain. Control is achieved by using a flow-through carbon filter or by adding engineered vapor-adsorbing carbon sheets to the top of the air filter box or the duct. When implemented correctly, the air induction emissions can drop to 10 to 50 milligrams a day. When the car is restarted, the adsorbed hydrocarbons are purged from the sheet and burned in the engine. With an allotment of 180 milligrams remaining for the fuel system, material selection is crucial. Hydrocarbons will permeate substandard materials. Evaporative emission control is directly related to the type of materials used to make the gas tank, fuel lines, and parts that seal and connect these components. This brings us to the final and perhaps most important piece of the emission control strategy: the carbon canister. Due to their limited capacity, carbon canisters used in China today are unable to capture all the emissions generated during a refueling or 2-day diurnal event. However, upcoming requirements will result in the replacement of the current carbon canister with a larger ORVR carbon canister that can capture more than 98% of emissions, both refueling and diurnal. Special consideration of design and materials will be necessary to reach the highest level of control and the allotment target. It's important to note that all emission control measures must function the life of the vehicle, defined as 160,000 kilometers. So the canister and the carbon inside are critical to meeting and maintaining compliance. Here are some of the factors that can influence diurnal emissions. This canister is in a car that has just been parked for the weekend. Hydrocarbon vapors begin to flow out of the tank and into the canister. Initially, the vapors are more concentrated on the tank side. Over time, the vapors diffuse and eventually reach the atmosphere side. The next time the car is driven, the onboard computer will open a valve and the manifold vacuum will pull clean air into the canister, purging the hydrocarbons from the carbon. The vapors then head to the engine and are burned as fuel. If the carbon is purged quickly and efficiently, the canister is ready for the next parking event. If not, there is less capacity to capture the hydrocarbons and vehicle emissions will rise. China 6 will require more aggressive purge calibration across the drive cycle. The Type 4 diurnal test starts by preconditioning a vehicle. Preconditioning includes a series of predetermined steps and ends with the loading of the canister with butane. Once the vehicle reaches a defined state, the test begins with an elevated temperature soak, followed by a controlled elevated temperature drive cycle that simulates real-world driving conditions. The vehicle then enters a shed, and emissions are measured during a hot soak test. The vehicle cools and soaks for up to 36 hours before entering the two-day diurnal emission test. The emissions are monitored as temperatures rise and fall in the shed. The test result is the sum of the emissions measured during the hot soak, the higher of the two-day diurnal emission values, and an assigned or measured deterioration factor. This car passes, due in great part to the car's purge volume and the type of carbon in the canister. Not all carbons purge or age equally. Activated carbon can be created using olive pits or coal. However, wood is the predominant raw material. They all have some ability to adsorb hydrocarbons, but capacity and durability vary. The capacity and emissions are related to the heel of the carbon. The heel is the amount of hydrocarbons that are adsorbed by the small pores of the carbon, but are not released during purge. The higher the heel, the less space available for capturing the next cycle of emissions. Pore structure is one reason Ingevity carbons perform better than competitive material. These results show the significant advantage of Ingevity's uniquely produced wood-based carbon, lower heel and less aging effect. Real-world studies show how these products performed over time. The Swedish Road Administration tested in-service vehicles in Sweden for evaporative emissions. The vehicles were diverse in both age and mileage. About half the cars tested in Sweden failed evaporative emissions tests. The failed vehicles primarily contained olive-based or a competitor's wood-based carbon. Cars containing Ingevity carbon passed every time. A canister's performance can be greatly increased by using the innovative resources provided by Ingevity. These are two-day emissions test results. The canister's volume and purge are identical, and the carbon types can be layered for even greater effect. Most manufacturers complying with current US evaporative emission regulations use these methods. There are special cases that require advanced engineering. Hybrids, for example, have a reduced purge volume since they are operating on battery power for a portion of the drive cycle. Ironically, without layering and engineered materials, these environmentally friendly cars may need additional technology to pass certification and in-use emissions tests. The solution can be as simple as a properly placed Ingevity honeycomb, engineered to provide high efficiency with low to no pressure drop. This translates into outstanding diurnal emission control without impacting refueling performance. Complying with China 6 requires finding a balance between design, materials, and purge. However, compliance does not have to be a painstaking process of trial and error. Ingevity offers over 40 years of experience in the science of evaporative emission control. We can test and recommend innovative carbon solutions for canisters and air induction systems that meet China 6 ORVR and diurnal regulations. Deliver quality carbons produced in our US and China manufacturing sites, which meet China 6 emission control needs. Assist and advise on full vehicle ORVR and diurnal testing and fuel system design, and through experienced world-class manufacturing and technical support, provide customers with confidence that the carbon in their emission control system will perform reliably year after year. Contact Ingevity today. We are here to help you meet China 6 and beyond.